Best of r/TalesFromRetail Episode 2. Many, many years ago, in the dark and distant past of late 90s Peterborough, England, I used to work in a chain bookstore, the chain long defunct in the store now a camping gear shop, as a retail assistant, shelf stacker, cleaner etc. I exclusively worked weekends and Thursday evenings as I was a mere teenager and still a sixth form. Anyway, on one particularly busy Saturday I was working the front desk until which faced the open front doors of the store into the city center shopping area. An older lady, easily in her 80s, stood in the doorway looking around then made her way directly to me and asked me what was possibly the weirdest question of my short-lived book-selling career. "Excuse me, where are your pots and pans?" The limited training I had received had not prepared me for this. I'm sorry but we don't sell pots and pans. We're a bookshop. Don't play silly games with me, young man. You've got them in your window. We didn't. I'm sorry, we don't. We don't sell pots and pans, we sell books. Well, you were selling pots and pans last week. Where are they now? She was now getting quite agitated. Sorry, but we've never sold pots and pans. We're a bookshop. We sell books. I demand to see the manager. Okay, I'll get him. I called for the manager on his radio, and as he was on the ground floor, he came straight over. "What's up, OP?" Before I get a chance to answer, the customer cuts in. "This young man is being dreadfully unhelpful and won't help me find what I'm looking for." The manager gives me a sideways look. He'd been working there for a while and he knew that I was pretty good at sourcing books for customers. "Okay, well let's see if I can find the book for you. What's the title?" "I'm not after a bloody book. I want a new saucepan." This went on with the manager having almost exactly the same conversation with her. Eventually she concedes that she might be in the wrong shop. Turns out that she thought that she was in the cookware shop on the same street with the same color frontage, but at the opposite end. She slunk off claiming that young people were ignorant and rude. TLDR. Lady goes into bookshop and demands pots and pans. "Thank you, next." Full disclosure, I don't work in retail but I do work in retail stores exclusively. I'm a refrigeration engineer. I work the contract for a large supermarket. Look after 100 plus stores/distribution hubs. As such, my work gear has the supermarket name on it so customers are forever asking me questions. But you gotta love it, you get to meet such interesting, obtuse, and vibrant, insane, people. While fitting a case controller, barriers up and tools out, I get two ladies come up to me brandishing a bottle of store-owned spirit. They proceeded to tell me that all of this particular spirit on the shelves was out of date, that it was a disgrace and so on. Also to note, they had another 15 or so bottles in the trolley. The conversation went as follows. Me, grumpy fridging. Turnip, main lady. Donut, main lady's second. Donut, we had already loaded up our trolley for Christmas, then we just happened to check the date. Turnip, it's ridiculous. Me, it really is ridiculous. Turnip, oh you agree. Me, yes, this whole situation is ridiculous. You see, that's the bottle date, not a sell-by date. Also, I am pretty sure a sealed bottle of 40% alcohol is not going to go out of date at all. Turnip, I am not sure I believe you, you're just a cleaner anyway. Me, looks at tools and wiring. Me, okay, if that's your thinking then why bother asking me at all? Turnip, well I thought you might want to know it's out of date. Me, no I don't want to know and no it's not out of date. Turnip, HMMMPH. Me, now if you would like to whisk yourselves down to checkouts, there's a lovely manager named Linda who'll tell you the same thing. Turnip and donut. Me, now, if you wouldn't mind gestures down the aisle. A bit later a manager comes and finds me. Checkouts manager, you all right there? Me, splendid, you? Manager, good thanks. Did you have a lady talking to you about out of date spirit? Me, laughing yeah. Manager, she reckoned you were quite unhelpful and rude. Me, unhelpful and rude? Perfect. What did they do with all that stuff in the end? Manager, tried to get it at a discount and then left it all on the checkout when I said no. Me, amazing. Manager, I know that was pretty silly but try and be nice, Christmas is coming up. Me, I'll see what I can do. Thank you, next. Today, I checked out a customer who bought one small item. She also had a large bag over her shoulder, so I figured she would either pocket the item or toss it in her bag. My store doesn't have a policy on whether to offer bags or not. Typically, I just gauge whether or not to ask the customer if they want one if they're buying a fair amount of stuff, or don't have a bag with them. After I checked out the customer, she lingered at my counter, just looking at me. I asked her if there was anything else I could do for her. "Why didn't you ask me if I wanted a bag?" she asked. "Well, I saw that you were carrying a bag and thought you might put your item in there," I said. "But I'm more than happy to grab you a bag. Would you like one?" "No," she said, and then asked, "Do you ask everyone if they want a bag?" "Nope, I only ask if they're buying large items and don't have their own bag." She then just turned and left. Not the biggest deal, but why ask me why I didn't ask you if you wanted a bag if you didn't want one to begin with? Thank you. Next, I'm enjoying my joy chocolate when the door opens and a guy comes in. He struts up to the cash and says, "Will you accept this bill?" So I look over the counter and I expect him to start unfolding the bill. Nope. He is holding the bottom corner of a $5 bill. As I'm typing this, he just showed back up outside and is digging through the bus stop for cigarette butts. Just thought I'd add that little tidbit as I continue my story. So yeah, he's holding the bottom corner of a $5 bill with the serial number. For your understanding of the rest of the story, after he left, I measured what I think is close to what he had, which was 1 inch height, 3 inches width. Me: nah, I can't accept that. Him: well, why not? Me: that's not even a quarter of a bill. Him: well, the internet said you have to accept it if it's still 45% of a bill or still shows a serial number. Me: well, the internet is wrong. Him: no, legally you have to accept this. Me: legally, I can deny a perfect $50 bill if I want to. This is a store. I don't have to accept anything, and I'm absolutely not going to accept a bill that is no longer legal tender. Him: it is legal tender because the serial number is still there. Me: using your logic, I could cut up this $50 bill I have in the till into 2-3 sections. Two showing the serial numbers and the third being 45% of the remaining bill, and just go to different stores and get $150 out of the one bill. That doesn't make sense. That doesn't exist. I'm not accepting that. Him: well, I'm gonna come back with a printout of the laws I found online. Me: you do that. There's nothing you can bring to me that's going to make me accept that. He left, and like I said, he's now digging through the bus stop instead of printing off laws that don't exist. Thank you. Next. Edit: thanks for the silver. Okay, first post, on mobile etc. This is probably going to be long because it was a few separate encounters, so sorry in advance. Background: I worked in a small town electronics slash appliance store when I was in high school, 2015. I was only a temporary Christmas worker, so I wasn't till trained. My job was to help with incoming stock, stock shelves, keep the store tidy and help customers to the best of my ability, and then hand them off to the full-timers to complete the sale. I'm quite tech inclined and could usually help out with what customers are asking, but if I got out of my depth, I'd ask one of the full-time staff to assist. Okay, onto the story. Cast: me equals little teenage boy, Annie, full-time co-worker. Dad: main harasser, not my dad. Mum: his wife. Girl: their daughter. Boy: their son. So I was stocking shelves one day when it was pretty quiet and this family came in. Dad immediately beelines for me and tells me they need a tablet. Okay, no worries. We have a tablet station set up with all of the Android tablets and then a separate display for the iPads because Apple likes to be different. Kids go off to play on iPads. Dad wanders off and I ask Mum what they need the tablet for, etc. She says it's for girls' school work. She says very shyly that she wants the cheapest tablet, important for later. Sweet. I show her the cheapest one and it fits all her requirements. Okay, time to go out the back and get a boxed one. Dad comes back over and immediately starts asking why we went for that one. I try to explain that it's our cheapest option and he starts grilling me on what the difference is between that one and a Samsung one. Well, the price, for a start. Samsung was a solid $400 more. He gets super in depth, grilling me about specifics of the tablets. I'm not an expert on Android. I'm better with Apple, so I say I'm not sure, but let me grab someone who will know and signal to Annie, who is at the counter. She comes over. Dad explodes. No, you need to finish doing your job. To Annie. Nope, go away. She hasn't finished her job. This goes on for a few minutes while I try to get a word in. Annie, who has heard everything, says, actually, she's a trainee. Her job is to help as much as she can and then get one of us. She's done her job. Dad gets in a huff but finally shuts up. Annie and Mum decide on the cheaper tablet. Annie goes out back to get the boxed one. Dad goes to get kids from iPads and asks me what are these? I tell him they're iPads. Why didn't you show us these? Because Mum asked to see the cheapest option and these start at around $500. Dad looks pissed and says I want one of these. Mum and I are dumbfounded. Dad is insistent and so Annie and I get them sorted on which one slash storage size etc. They end up spending $500 more than planned. Mum is not happy but I get the vibe she doesn't want to stand up to Dad. They head to the counter to buy, and Annie asks how they'd like to pay. Dad puts a lottery ticket on the counter. Not a winning one. Just trash he had in his pocket. Cracks up like it's the funniest joke. Howling with laughter. Annie and I are not having it. Annie asks again, and Mum reluctantly hands over credit card. They pay, and, finally, leave. Bro. Nightmare over. JK. They come in the next day. They don't know how to set up the iPad. Our store offered tech solution slash help with tech etc but usually it's a paid service through a separate part of the company where someone books and then a solutions employee will come to the store. We don't usually sit there and help out ourselves, because we aren't trained for it and we don't get paid for it, unless it's a quick fix or you're extra nice. Family comes in, sits at our finance desk, asks for help setting up iPad. I'm not there yet. I didn't start until 11 that day but Dad insists they only want me to help them, so they hang around. As soon as I walk in, we entered through front doors and walked to back room through the store. He grabs me and tries to pull me over to them. I haven't even clocked in or out my stuff away. I'm trying to tell him this but he's breaking out the "you need to do your job" spiel again. Never mind that setting up your iPad isn't actually my job. It took another employee intervening before he would let me go upstairs. I clock an ETC and, reluctantly, head back out. They're still waiting for me. Luckily, I actually know a lot about Apple so it's not a huge task for me to set up an iPad, though the fact that they didn't have an email address, who TF doesn't have an email address, didn't help. Took me 3 hours in the end because Mum didn't understand a lot of it. Dad left and came back with food. Tried to give me a donut. I declined. Not to be rude but mostly because I'd already eaten and it seemed wrong to take food from a customer slash stranger. He kept trying to shove it in my face and then eventually decided to eat it himself. I was very stoked when I finally saw the home screen of the iPad and I could send them TF home. I won't keep going on here because this is super long already, but they came in a few more times. Bought another tablet that was super expensive. WTF. And then there was another time that he accosted me outside the store demanding I sell him a phone, and then had a massive argument with me when I tried to sell him said phone. TL. Doctor, family comes in looking for a cheap tablet, accuse me of not doing my job, buy expensive iPad, need help setting up said iPad, generally waste my time and harass me, thank you. Next. Standard issue warning. On mobile. Happened a couple months back. Probably could have handled it better but fuck it, I didn't lose my job. I work in Yellowstone National Park, and this most recent summer I worked in the gift shop. On this particular day it was peak season, guests flowing in from every direction, and I was in the bigger of our two stores with an incompetent coworker. I left my register during a small dip in speed to just run and grab any unfolded shirts to take back to the reg. In those 5 seconds of speed walking around the store, a line formed and my co-worker was taking his sweet time dealing with it, so I start calling guests over to check them out, and the line isn't going down. But of course during this rush I get an aggressive guest lameo. Me. Moose lady, ML. ML. Yesterday I saw a sculpture of a moose and didn't get it and now I don't see it. Can you check in the back and see if you still have one? Me. Yes. But I need to get this line under control before I can go down. Is it okay if you wait a couple minutes? ML. No. You said you could help the next guest and I am the next guest. Now go get me a moose. Me. I'm sorry mom, I wasn't here yesterday and didn't see the moose, so I'm not even sure what the moose looked like. My co-worker is new and I can't leave him alone in this rush. I'll go down as soon as I can. ML. I. Clap. Am. Clap. The. Clap. Next. Clap. Guest. Clap. Now go look in your moose section and find the sculpture. Now at this point the rush had died down, and I knew I didn't have a moose sculpture. The last time we got shipment was my Friday, and I did shipment. Ain't no moose. If a moose sculpture had come in, it would have been a return from another village in the park, and if it was already gone she was sol. I let her know that I'll run down and see, grab the keys and my vape, go down to the basement stockroom, do a quick lap around the stockroom, no fucking moose of course, and spend a solid 3 minutes chain vaping, doing a thorough check of the stockroom for any moose. Me. I'm sorry mom, I couldn't find it, it must have been the only one in stock. ML. You're such a fucking idiot. I can't believe you don't have a sculpture of a moose. Storms out yelling that she'll call the NPS on me. She came back the next day and made one of my sweetest co-workers ever cry by telling her how pretty she'd be if she just washed her face. Co-worker had chronic severe acne. Overall a terrible lady, and I'm glad that where I live you don't see the same people more than a couple times. Thank you. Next. It was Black Friday 2014. The department store was a scare. Children were screaming. Product was everywhere. I stood at my cash register, near a complete mental numb. The line weaved in, out, it never reduced by one. Suddenly a crash. What's this about? A boy, barely 14, started to shout. Mom, I hate this place. He said with a sneer. Why, oh why do I have to be here? His mother looked at him, and gave him a playful shove. It's Christmas, baby. It's time to spread love. The boy did not like that. He did not like that one bit. He looked to his mother and planned his hit. His fist was raised, ready to blast his birth jiver. Too much time had passed. The boy's hand was starting to quiver. He couldn't do it. I said in my head. If I did that to my mama, I would be dead. His knuckles slowly lowered into two open palms. Okay. I thought, maybe nothing will go wrong. Instead he delivered a massive shove to his mom. And there it stood, a misfortunately placed clothing rack, with a metal lip and teeth that can bite back. Not to say it was attractive, but the rack did catch that mother's eye. Blood spouted, staining clothes like primitive red dye. The boy was mortified from the resulting howl. Blood everywhere, his mother he assumed was disemboweled. He grabbed white hoodies and thrusted them towards her face. It was too late to contain. Her blood left its mark on this place. A minute did not pass before she stood up, and said, I refuse to pay. I replied, Mom, you're injured. You don't have to worry about that today. She paused and gave me a squint through her rose-tinted vision. She grabbed her kid and left. This Karen refuses to listen.